Hello, voiders, and welcome to a fresh edition of I Hate Sundays. Starting on a Saturday, and things are actually incredibly confusing today because we have an event to go to. So, like 3 weeks ago, we booked tickets for this event called Basic Bitch Pop-Up. And it was originally supposed to be this like basic bitch kind of thing with a lot of Insta shit, with a lot of pink cocktails, with a lot of Britney songs and all that sort of shit. And then like 3-4 days ago, I log onto the Fever app and then find out that its name has been changed from Basic Bitch Pop-Up to Saved by the Beer Fest, the 90s party.
How dare you?
And the Basic Bitch Pop-Up was supposed to go from 11 a.m. to 12 p.m. to 12 a.m. And this one's going from 6:30 p.m. to 10 p.m. And we really have no idea what's going to await us, how much basic bitchiness is going to happen, how much beer festness is going to happen, how 90s is this going to be? Is there anything at all since everything got so confusing? Let's go downtown LA and find the fuck out. So here we are. See the line building behind me? That's where we're going. Nobody in this line actually really knows what's going on. They're just as clueless as we are. I feel like Mark Wahlberg in The Happening.
What? No.
So, we just found out that this still is the Basic Bitch Pop-Up. But the thing is, they couldn't promote the word bitch. So that's why they changed it to Saved by the Beer Fest. I'm feeling better about this show now. So we just walked in here and we were first presented with some Lunchables, which is so fucking 90s. And as the intro for the evening, we got ourselves some Starbust Jello shots in a needle, which is cherry flavored, which is fucking insane. And they're playing Guns N' Roses! On guard! Ha! On guard! Cheers!
The band's gonna start soon. I read their set list. It seems like they're
the Offspring cover band. I'm gonna die.
I got these sunglasses, goddamn.
Yeah. Morning. Hangover's pretty heavy on this one. Spent the day editing so far. Last week, Sunday. And, today, we got some shit going on. Remember last week when this happened? When we wanted to see underwater. And this happened. Oh my god, this is so embarrassing. I bought tickets for the wrong theater while I was totally high. Oh. Don't tell anybody this happened. We're gonna do this next week, okay guys? We're gonna do this next week, I promise you. Yeah. We're gonna watch underwater now. What I want to say. Yeah, and later on we're going to a party at Marcel's, so looking forward to some fun. I got a day with yeah. Them now. I still hate the movie. So today I have absolutely no idea what to expect. Like, I've been trying to keep away from any spoilers of this movie whatsoever. I haven't checked a single review. Once I saw a small trailer on the CW, even though I did not want to while I was watching Riverdale, mind you. I just know Kristen Stewart has a shaved head. And that this movie was originally made in 2017, and I don't know why it's coming out now and didn't come earlier. And I'm actually looking forward to this, like a nice old little space creature feature. So let's see what happens.
The world's oceans are largely unexplored, but thanks to scientists, explorers, treasure hunters, and wealthy investors, we are finding new things every day.
Oh my god, talk about mixed bag on this one. This was not good, but this was also not bad either. There's so many things about this movie that I really, really loved. And so many things that I truly, truly, downright despised. So, there is really a lot to talk about here. Let me process a little. I think we're gonna talk about this at home. Cut to there. Okay, I'm gonna start talking about the positives of this movie. And this is actually, I'm doing something very dangerous because my sister's in the background who truly hated this movie. And she's gonna hate everything positive I have to say about it. Okay, let's get this going. So. With that being said, you can toss in any objections if you want to, by the way. The best thing about this movie is Kristen Stewart's performance. Definitely. Like, hands down, that is, like, the best thing ever here. And, like, you can really totally see anybody who is stuck in their stupid little Twilight box. I recommend you to just see this movie alone for Kristen Stewart's performance, because this just simply shows what kind of an amazing actress she has become during the recent years. Because, like, if anything is carrying this movie, that is her fucking performance. And she is doing an amazing job here. Other performances that I have to give credit for. There's two performances I also really enjoyed. Jessica Henrich and Vincent Cassel. Good job, guys. Like, they were the only ones besides Kristen Stewart who were carrying this movie. Everybody else, was just so plain and generic and forgettable. But I'm going to talk about that later. What I also noticed about this movie, it seems to have taken like a lot of inspirations from the big greats, like movies like The Thing, Alien, maybe even Event Horizon a little bit. And you get a lot of nods to those films in this movie. Like, especially there is one scene where the monster in this movie is like really facing Kristen Stewart's character, and it honestly reminds you of that iconic scene in Alien where Ripley is like right in front of the alien and pretending not to move. It's like really giving nods to films like that.
But there is not much monster in this movie. If you expect this to be a monster movie, it's not. It is definitely not.
I'm going to get to that later. What else I really liked here is the cinematography. Oh, eye candy, beautiful. If you enjoy explosions, especially explosions underwater, which are very hard to make look good, this is good. This is like really good. Like the way these explosions are designed, generally the way the action sequences of the movie are made, beautiful. Like actually a remarkable job. The monster in this movie also looks fantastic because it doesn't look CGI-ish at all. It's actually like a quite believable monster. You actually feel like the monster is actually there. You don't get that Marvel look where everything looks absolutely synthetic. And those are basically like the good parts of the that the movie has to offer. It has an incredible opening, a very impressive ending, but then we get to the middle. And now let's talk about the things that were not so good about this movie. Except for Kristen Stewart's character and Jessica Henwick's character, you don't really give a shit about anybody. And that is the problem. Because this movie really, really, really wants you to care about its characters. But you don't. You're just being thrown into a situation. You don't get a backstory about anyone. You don't really...
Not
even how long they've been underwater. It's just like...
Why they're underwater? What their general situation is. There is no general situation.
They're just at a drill station. But like, what's going on? How they've been doing? Nothing.
And you still need a moment to get that it's a drill station. You need a moment for that.
Except for Kirsten Stewart and Vanessa's character, there isn't any character development at all, really, here.
No.
Like, nothing. And, sort of, the basic problem with the movie is it gets very redundant.
Totally.
See,
totally.
What the movie manages to do great is that it sets tone very well. It sets its tone perfectly. But that is also where the movie kind of kills itself, because the tone is just so specific. And it just doesn't leave this tone that you get very bored very quickly. You're basically watching this scenario. Our aquatic friends are chilling. There's an explosion and everything goes awry. And then they chill again. And then there's an explosion and everything goes awry. And then they chill again and... it's redundant. It keeps happening over and over again. And that is basically 90 minutes of they hang out, surviving, fighting the good fight. And then there's an explosion and everything goes awry. It gets boring very fast. And it's like you feel bad for this movie because it deserves so much more. There's great effects. The sea creature looks amazing. But its redundancy and its lack of character just lets you down.
And this sea creature that doesn't really matter, who's here like for like all 5 seconds of the movie and does not have anything to do with the storyline, all of a sudden there's a sea creature. Nobody battles it, really. Like, it's just here. Like, all of a sudden there's a sea creature. Let's look at it for like 5 fucking seconds.
Yeah, that's the thing. I want this threat underwater to be more of a threat. I know you're trying. I know they were trying to go for the humanity in this, trying to make the story be a story about survival and less about the creature that is actually attacking our characters. But
there was all 5 seconds.
You can't make a character study without any characters. So, like, why not focus on the creature? Something that irritated me so much in this movie, and like, it's so silly because I was just talking about how amazing the effects were. But the makeup, oh my god. There is this scar Kirsten Stewart has on her cheek that looks like somebody took like a magic marker and just drew a line on her face. And that doesn't change. It remains the same through the entire movie. So yeah, you get like, I feel very extreme about this movie. There's a lot of things about it I love, but there's a lot of things about it I hate. It's not good. It's not a disaster either. I say, watch it on VOD, on Netflix, or on like any streaming service when it's available, but don't waste your money on it. It's okay, but the bad kind of okay. So, Marcel is throwing another party tonight, and I am feeling especially spunky. Look at my fucking outfit. Don't look beautiful. We're late. We still gotta pick up J-Cam, and we still gotta get some booze at Bogey's Liquor. So let's go, let's go, let's go!
Merci!
French!
Uh-oh. There's pretty boy.
Uh-oh.
Oh. Frenchie, how you doing?
Hi, good!
Oh, thank you.
Tyler!
What's going on?
He's back! He's been gone for so long.
Yes.
Long time.
Hey! Ivan! Go for Pat!
It's pretty boy!
Oh, I missed.
So we're hanging at Marcel's party.
What happened?
Go.
The voiders are watching us.
Hi, voiders.
Who are you watching this?
YouTube channel viewers. They're called the voiders.
Voiders.
The voiders, yes.
Hi, voider.
Hey.
Did you see the glove?
The remake or the original?
When they came out 2 weeks ago?
Yeah.
I'm sorry, I haven't seen the remake.
It's good.
Isn't I like it. Everybody says it sucks ass, but I like it.
I like Lynn, so I'll watch anything with her.
Right? I agree.
She fucking brings it home.
Put that thing back in the garbage where it belongs.
I'm having a very distinguished moment with Kwame.
Oh, yes, Jesus.
What were
you
telling your housekeeper the other day?
I was telling my housekeeper she's sweeping up all the stuff in the room. She goes, is this all your little boys? And I go, that's not my little boy, that's a monkey.
My time has come. So it shivers down my spine. Body's aching all the time. Goodbye, everybody. I've got to go.
No,
gotta leave you all behind. Sometimes wish I'd never been born at all.
Oh, you're so cute.
Aww.
I'm gonna tune my air guitar.
Let's do the wedding girl thing.
Everybody get ready, get ready, get ready.
I see a little silhouette of a man. Scaramouche, scaramouche, let it do the bandando. But the monster lightning, baby, baby, loves me. He's just a poor boy from a poor family. Staring his life from his monstrosity. Easy come, easy go. Will you let me go? Wish me luck.
No, we will not let you go.
Yeah.
Loves me. No, we will not let you go.
Oh, Mamma Mia, Mamma Mia!
Yes, but for me!
Anywhere the wind blows.
Eliza, you did such an amazing job.
Oh my god, you can sing. Never knew that about you.
It's on.
Look who's back, guys. Look who's back.
Look who's back. The cutest little dog in the world. Yes.
Hello. How are you doing? I missed you so much. So much. You are the cutest little dog in the world. Oh, I love you.
We are dancing one last time. It's getting colder. There is something in her eyes that makes me want to hold her. My touch.
Dance your heart out.
Dance.
Come on, dance.
But I mean, I'm comfortable.
Shows what you got.
Because I am.
Imagine you're dancing down the hallway and you don't realize there's a
color.
Come on, dance.
Our generation is so wrong. Everybody's on their phone. Oh my god. Let's kill each other.
See me, I don't give a fuck living life, that's how we be.